All right, doggies, let's get wet!
Hi folks, I am Jim Zelasco. It is the June Bloom in Millersville, Maryland. We're having a wonderful time, just hanging out, jumping dogs with friends, and having a great event here. It's become a little bit overcast, but we are having fun. And you know, there's some big jumping dogs, there's new dogs as always. And it's just a great event, so we're having a great time.
I'll bet those dogs are getting heavy. I should have just taken my time. This was a national event and a sanctioned facility event. It was also this facility's very first event. I'm starting to better understand these newly formed sanctioned facilities. I have now attended a few of their very first DOckDogs competitions, and I have to keep in mind that in some cases, they are learning as they go. So I'm witnessing these events at what's probably their most vulnerable time. I'm mindful of this, and I understand that in most cases, the events at these facilities will get better and better with time. But so far, there are some distinct differences between a sanctioned facility and other DOckDogs events. For one, if you're looking forward to large crowds of spectators oohing and aahing, that's not likely going to happen. There's also not likely going to be that electricity in the air with no big audience to play off of. Competitors rooting for one another is always a DOckDogs tradition. But many are busy with their own dogs, and without an experienced MC working the music and competitors, the environment may seem somewhat subdued. For another thing, when it comes to the dock, they are all different with a different feel. Yes, they are regulation, but no two seem the same. I hope that didn't come off sounding negative, because it's definitely not supposed to be. Sometimes it's nice not having to fight a crowd to take pictures and not having to weave your way around flexi lead groupies. Many competitors like a laid-back, chilled-out atmosphere. I think that it provides a greater opportunity to meet new friends and get to know others better. So if that's for you, you'll like the sanctioned facility events. But if you crave the large crowds and electricity in the air, I don't think you'll find those to be common at any sanctioned facility event. As for this particular event, it came off as a sanctioned facility just like I described, laid-back and pleasant. In fact, almost too pleasant at first. But as the weekend wore on, the intensity picked up a little. With very little spectators, it was incumbent upon the competitors to create the electricity, but they got the job done nicely. When you first check in, you were handed a nice bag of goodies and a t-shirt commemorating the event. A very nice and thoughtful touch. The grounds of this facility are nice and very good size to accommodate the competition easily. There's plenty of space for Dogtown, but with this type of layout, people may ask why they couldn't have their vehicles right at their tents. My understanding is that there was some sort of irrigation system in place preventing that. Completely understandable. But cars were not very far away at all, and if you really wanted to just work directly from your car, you could. The pool and dock were nice, even including ramps instead of stairs for entry and exit. I do have to ask though, where was the dock clock? DOckDogs headquarters, and probably the crew too, most likely cringe now every time I point out when a clock is missing. But now having experienced its benefits, it seems like such an essential tool. I've utilized the clock not only as a competitor, but also as a spectator taking pictures or video. I know that when the time nears the end, something is going to happen, and I should be ready with my camera. I've also seen its benefits as someone helping run a competition. The clock not only keeps the show rolling, but is extremely useful to keep practice time fair and moving along as well. The staging area for the dogs is great. Grassy and no cross traffic from other dogs. Porta potty restrooms for humans were convenient and line free. Facilities for the doggies was pleasant, and you could easily space yourself away from the competition and other dogs so your dog could do their business. You could camp at this facility if you wanted to for a small fee. No hookups available, but your proximity to the competition area is very convenient. I didn't see any tent camping, but if I return, I may give that a try. The weather was great for it this year, but no showers are available, so I'd have to get creative. The competition itself was very well run. Everything ran on time for the most part. Finals on the last day got started late for some reason, but nobody really seemed to mind. To sum it up, I'd say that it was a very successful DOckDogs event, and pretty much everything from the gracious host to the crab feast to the exciting finals made for a very nice weekend hanging out with friends and playing with dogs. Thanks for watching another episode of Dock Diving Tales. Up next, look for me at the Eastern Regionals at the Wisp Resort in Maryland this coming weekend. Until then, keep admiring the best thing you've ever brought back from any dock diving event, your dog.
I show a rosy on my chest, 'cause I'm a wanderer. I'm a wanderer.